Okay, we're gonna learn how to calculate ending inventory and cost of goods sold under the periodic method using the average cost method. Very, very simple. Let's look at the information. Our beginning inventory at the beginning of this year, think January 1st, 400 units, $13 a unit for a total of 5,200. We made four purchases during the year. These are the units, the cost per unit. This is the total dollar amount, 600 times 1350 is 81, et cetera. Beginning inventory plus purchases equals the total units available for sale. And the dollar amounts here, this is cost of goods available for sale. Now down below, let's look at the what we call the account, the cost of goods sold equation. Beginning inventory plus purchases equals cost of goods available. And notice for all three methods, FIFO, LIFO, and average cost, it's the same. That's very useful to know. What'll be different is ending inventory and cost of goods sold. This is the easiest of the three methods. So to calculate ending inventory and cost of goods sold, two steps. First, take your cost of goods available and divide it by the units available. Cost of goods available, $37,100 divided by 2,600 units equals 14.269. Why don't we just call it 14.27? This is step one. Okay, $14.27. Recognize there might be a slight rounding error as a result. Step two, we're gonna take 14.27 and we're gonna multiply it times 1,900 units. And this will give us cost of goods sold. And then we're gonna multiply it times 700 units. And this is gonna give us ending inventory. Okay, so 1427 times 1,900 units is 27,113. And we can put that down here, 27,113. And again, you could calculate ending inventory by simply taking cost of goods available minus cost of goods sold will give us ending inventory. Or we can multiply the $14.27, this is the average cost per unit, times 700 units, and that will be $99.89. And again, we're gonna have a slight rounding error, and that's because we truncated the decimal here. It actually goes out an awfully long way, so we simply cut it down to the nearest penny, and that'll get us pretty darn close. And that's how you do that's how you do average cost to calculate ending inventory and cost of goods sold.